Hey everybody, so I'm Lindsay Smith, and today we are going to be working on my amazing, talented cousin's photo. This is him and his bride-to-be. I've got a bunch of my actions opened up in this panel, from the sharpen focus areas, La Touche Finale, which is my favorite. I use them on all of my images. Mommy. Advanced retouch, the gaining ground, and the sweet apple bites. So I'm going to go back to that mode. Install actions. Go back to my other videos. I explain how to install your actions. So it is a little bit underexposed. So I'm going into the gaining ground. I believe is the one right after this. And we can turn our opacity down. I'm going to invert my mask, so Control I. I'm just going to paint it with a soft white brush over them. Kind of give them a spotlight. I'm going to go up to my retouch. I'm just going to retouch them really quickly. There's a few spots on here that. Oops. It's like my background. See, because they are a little further away, we don't really see their facial features as much in this image up close, so it's just going to be a super quick, let me just merge these, touch up. So I'm going to go into my advanced retouch, which is really nice to have. You have everything from your eye retouch, your lip retouch, skin retouch, color casting, and finishing. So I'm just going to go with the natural skin smoother. It's just going to take a minute to populate. I did not expect it to take this long. I don't know if it's because I'm taping as well. The reason why it's really bogged down. My laptop only has an i3, and processor and your RAM definitely has a lot to do with how fast your software is going to process and load actions. So just keep that in mind. So I, again, am on my laptop. And it is an i3, and it is only 8 gigs of RAM. So my desktop has a little bit more of a meatier process. It is an i7 with, I believe, 16 gigs. So it kind of zips a little faster than this. But my laptop has not done me wrong, and it's super convenient to do while I'm in bed. So I'm just going to let this take a minute. make those videos running in the background. And I'm going to say it probably was. I should have shut all that up. So with a soft white brush, I'm just taking all of them, dragging it to the left to change my brush. Now, being close up, you can't really see what is going on here. You can't see all of the blurring, in essence, of what it's doing. With guys, I don't like to blur them out so much. But we'll back out so you can see. It's really subtle, but you can see it in her face and his. It just softens up. Okay, so I am also going to whiten their eye whites a little bit. I don't like to go too overboard because then they look a little alien. So let me just back out and check that. It's not too bad. I am also going to come down here in my gaining ground. I'm going to select my lasso, pull down my shift key, and I'm going to highlight areas that maybe the sun would naturally hit. Now he is facing the sun a little more than she is, so she technically wouldn't get as much, but I'm just going to add a little bit of highlight in there because I want her face to have a little bit of dimension. And you can do as little or as much as you want. I think that's good. So then I'm going to select highlight. It's going to tell you to take your lasso and shift, but if you're already familiar, go ahead and do that and just click continue. And then set your feathers so that your highlights aren't very harsh. Continue. And then so what that means, you can see how harsh the outline is. We're going to just bump up feathering pixels here to about there. So you can see the dimension pop that we've got going on. Gives their face a little bit more shape, a little bit more contrast, and so I think that looks really nice. I am also going to go back up into my advanced retouch. I am going to grab Rosy Cheeks, and I'm gonna paint her cheeks here. And I'm gonna take that opacity down starting at 10 because I just want her to have a little bit of a blush going on, but not too much to take away from the highlighting we just did. Hold on, my phone is dinging. Okay, so we have our nice highlight pops. We have a little bit of a blush on her cheek because we are focusing on engagement photos right now. So, also, if you want to send me photos to edit and be featured in the YouTube, send them to me at support@ellisphotoshopactions.com. I'm hoping to jump in on these videos at least once a week, showing how what my actions do, and then I can also send you the finished edit that you can use if you would like, but just make sure to give me credit for editing, and I give you credit in the video with your media name. So let's carry on, shall we? Okay, so. Also, by the way, with the highlighting, you can do it to the hair, you can do it to clothes, you can do it to any place that you want to really stand out and highlight. I was just doing it in the face give them a little bit of shape, a little bit of dimension. I am going to go into, I might be done with the retouching, I'm not gonna lie, because there's not really a whole lot of retouching to be had. Really, this is a beautiful image straight out of camera. I'm just fixing the exposure and just a touch up, and we can already see what that little bit already did. I mean, really, that's all you would need for a clean image, and I think that looks so nice. But we are going to go ahead, because I do like to do a little bit of a creative, I like to get a little creative, so I'm going to create a snapshot, so that if I don't like what I do, it is right here, and I can go back to it, so before and after. So I am going to now flatten. Alright, so I am going to sharpen my details a little bit. It is going to be a high filter pass. See how they are very rainbowed? We don't want that so much. So I'm going to go down to an 8. And I'm just going to paint on with a soft white brush. Maybe want to stand out a little more. So like the details in her hair. And these are so easy to use. As you can see, you just click on them one time, and it's like, bam, you've got a little bit of more creative juice going on. Maybe we don't want to give his hair a little bit more. Jawline, pronounced. And I'm going to layer this down to probably 60. It just gives them, brings them into the focus a little bit more. Gives all the little fine details in your image a little bit more pop. Okay, so let's see. The Gaining Ground is a little bit more of a color scheme that we've got going on, so let's just play around and see we've got. So here is Peachy Keen. Oh, okay, so Control I. It doesn't do a whole lot because we have already got fall tones. So let's do, oh sorry, this is to be painted on them. I don't know what I was thinking, duh. So you would paint, these are little touch-ups. So if you want to give them a little bit of a peachy color to their skin, or tan, rosy cheeks, image boost. Let's lower that down to about 10 and see. Gives it a little bit more contrast. Let's go about 15. And it's also a painting one, so you can paint it on the areas that you would want to have a little bit more vibrancy. Okay. So let's see, old red. This gives it a little bit more red hues. So night blue. Puts blues into the shadow, that's kind of really neat. So, and then Divine Gold, magenta'd out. Nightfall. Have to fix that. Okay. Matte. And Dramatic Matte. I really liked the cinematic glue. I thought that was pretty. Adding in the blues, you can take it down to about 60. I feel like 60 is always like the magic number because it's never too much or too little. Okay, and then. And then I'm gonna do 4. Let's come down to our fall actions because we are getting ready to go into fall. Feel it's only appropriate. Probably could have been playing in that for a while now. Okay, so let's do apple bites. So that adds the red, and that's pretty, especially on the trees. Makes it look more golden hour. Warming filter just puts a little more warmth into it. Turn the grass yellow, so if you have pops of green in there that you don't want, you want it still a little bit more autumn, you can just click that and it'll take the greens. Oh, this might help if I turn my brush up. It'll turn any of the yellows or the greens turn the yellows to pumpkin. So these yellows back here, as you can see, it turned it all orange for that truly fall look. So we can turn this down. Let's try 60 because it's always the magic number. And then you can go in with a soft black brush. I'm going to go in about 40. I'm just gonna kind of paint it away from some of the spots around them. But as you can see, we still have, I'm gonna turn it up to 80. And then, let's see, marshmallow vignette. Or traditional vignette. I do love that burnt marshmallow though. And then we have some flares, amber waves, which is up top, and you can paint it off of your subject. And it's kind of that candy corn orange and yellow. Or you can do a ball of fire, and it can be moved. And then click our layer mask, kind of clean it off of them. Alright, and then, so, there you can see. Kind of give it a face. And then finishing touches, pop of contrast. We've got blast from the past. That looks really nice. Mold cider, which is a matte, and you can take a soft black brush and paint off of your subjects if you wanted to. Off the path. And give your image a kind of really fall feel. But I'm gonna leave that there And I'm going to, again, take a snapshot. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. Now, let's go back here, take a snapshot. Now, I'm going to flatten again. So, I'm going to come up to my Latouche, which is my absolute favorite, and we are going to run it. So, what you want to do with this? Open it up. Going to have specific details. So this spotlight, you want to brush it off of them. So at about 90%, I'm just going to, oh, it would help if I switch my brush. I'm just going to spotlight it around them. And I love, love, love the way that always looks when it turns out. When you start peeling it away almost. So I think that looks so nice. And then it does give you a few options, so you can put blue in your shadows, or you can hide it if you don't want the blue in your shadows. We have a blanket fade, so again, it was kind of like in the fall actions, the sweet apple bites, kind of like the amber waves, but this is any color that you decide to make it, or any gradient that you decide to make it, so we'll shut that off. And then this one is also contrast, but you can paint it off your subject's skin. So I feel like it looks better when it's painted off of the subject's skin, but sometimes it looks bright and you don't have to do that. But it can make the skin, if, especially if there's grain, it can make it kind of look a little bit gritty. But if that's what you're going for, then no big deal. Okay, so.
Mine.
That was the finale action. And let's take it down to the magic number of 60.
Mommy, mine.
And I think that looks really nice, but I'm gonna do one more thing just to try. I just wanna control I. I wanna put a on them because I feel like we also darken the image up, which is perfect for fall, don't get me wrong. But I still like my couples or the subjects of the image to kind of pop. I want them to stand out a little more. You know, because your eye is always drawn to the light in the image. So I still want to be eyes front and center on them. So, this is the finished image, finished fall image. So, let's go and check it out. So, we've got what we started with, which was beautiful on all in itself. And like I said, after the retouching and the brightening, really we didn't need to do anything else to it because this was the perfect clean image. And then we just kept going a little more. You could have stopped here if that was all the contrast you wanted to add. Then we added more fall tones. And then we added the Latouche, and it was a little bit dark. And then we added the light back in, and I think we nailed it. So I think it looks really good. And I think you can see what the actions have to offer. So, again, if you would like to see your images edited, send it to support@lsphotoshopactions.com. And thanks for checking this out.